Who said your knee could touch mine?
Who said?
Yeah.
I didn't.
Who are you?
Me.
How do you spell that?
Me.
That's not a spelling. You'd make a terrible B. Are you a meebee?
A meebee.
Is that like something that floats in the ocean?
No. That would be a flotsam or jetsam.
That's trash!
That's something that floats in the ocean.
Maybe in your polluted ocean. My ocean is not polluted.
So you must be from the pre-human period of this
book. Yes, I am! Angel.
Don't devils always lie?
Aren't devils really just angels?
Well, in case you're new to this, this is the 15-4 challenge, learning something new, where we challenge you to pick up something new or learn something more about something you enjoy, and do so by at least giving yourself 15 minutes a day, 4 days a week. And what we chose to do is to learn more about the Doumbek because we like drums, and the Doumbek is a fun instrument to play.
Jesse's been playing Doumbek for many years, but I've been playing Doumbek for now like 2 weeks.
And what we're doing is we've chosen some material, in this case, Rocky Danziger's Doumbek Fever book, and we're just going through the pages, and as we get more comfortable, we keep going a little further into the book.
And we do record this live Monday through Thursday at 7 p.m., but if you do miss it, you can go to our website, www.tribalsuitproject.com, and check out the recorded live feed.
Hi, Zach. Hi, Glendower. Hey, Zoe.
How can you see that?
Hi, Rebecca.
How can you see that?
Because I know what the letters look like when they're blurred, so I can put them together. It's like when you drive on a street and you see the street sign and you see how long the blur is.
Yes, you know what you're talking about.
You can kind of figure out what it is.
Yeah, only a blind person will understand.
That's right. All right, so we're going to do our practice, which is the Bambi. You remember what Bambi was?
Bambi's the little doe. No, he's not a doe, he's a boy.
That's right.
He's a little boy.
It goes, doom kaka tek kaka tek kaka tek kaka doom 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 kaka tek kaka tek kaka tek kaka doom 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 kaka tek kaka tek kaka tek kaka doom 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 kaka tek kaka tek kaka.
You didn't do nothing. You're a liar. You're a liar and a fibber McGee.
Hey, Frankie. How's it going, buddy? And there's Chris Murphy.
Hi!
All right, so we're going to go and play Malfouf and Baladee.
Malfouf, and then, all right, 4 Malfouf, 2 Baladee. Okay, so since I'm like...
Feeling so comfortable.
Since I feel comfortable, shut up, Jesse. So, one of the things that is kind of annoying to me about my own drumming thus far on the Doumbek is the whole mechanical monkey syndrome, which is just like, dot.
How did that go again?
Dot.
That's how I thought it was.
And you have to go like this when you do that? But no, so I want to kind of like try and start to shy away from that.
Sure.
Do you understand what I mean? I don't want to go like this. I want to go like
well,
this.
You know what Malfouf is? Right?
No. Can you play it for me? Alright, so I'm just gonna... I don't know why I had to say it out loud to tell you, because I could have just done it.
Well, I think the thing that she's trying to get here is that when you switch from twos to fours or fours to eights, there is a definitive speed change that occurs. And I think that's one of the things...
No, there's not.
Well, it's because you're playing a pattern, like you're playing 4 patterns of Malfouf to 2 patterns of ballet.
But that doesn't have anything to do with the speed.
Well, it's not, I said it's a perceived change in speed because...
Oh, I see what you're saying.
So you're stepping up or you're stepping down, which changes the groove of the piece.
Right.
So that's what I was trying to get across. Alright, so let's go Malfouf and Baladee.
Okay. We're going to say it first, right?
Sure.
Excuse me, I'm dying.
I was going to say, that's not even written in the book anymore. Ready?
Yes.
1, 2, ready, go.
Thank you.
Now we're going to play your favorite one. Maksum de Baladi.
Why is that my favorite? But I don't know if you guys could hear, but my father is clapping off in the distance. In the distance, he claps his hands.
Focus.
Because that's what he does. I don't have to focus. You can't make me.
Ready?
No!
Do you remember how that goes?
No.
Well, see it.
Why do I have to remember it if I can see it?
Well, because what if I went like this?
Then I guess I would just wait to see what you did. Jerk face. You're a jerk face. Oh, oh. You better settle down.
You're
settle down! You're out of control,
Jesse.
I'm not. I'm not.
Okay, here we go. Are
we
going to speak it?
Well, of course we are, because I don't. Doom tech, ka tech, doom ka tech, tech a doom tech, ka tech, doom ka tech, tech a doom doom
tech a tech, doom tech a tech.
Four.
That was four.
That was not?
Sure was.
No, it wasn't.
It was.
It wasn't.
We'll check the video later. I think it was
fun. We don't ever check the video.
Don't you? She watches it as soon as we're done.
I don't.
And then she'll watch it again later.
I do watch it as soon as we're done, but not for that.
Ready?
One, two, ready, go. Doom tech, ka tech, doom ka tech, tech a doom tech, ka tech, doom ka tech, tech a doom tech, ka tech, doom ka tech. Tech a doom tech ka tech doom ka tech tech a doom doom tech a tech doom tech a tech tech a doom doom tech a tech doom tech a tech tech a
So this one is Malfouf into Saidi. Now remember, Saidi and Baladi, though they kind of sound
similar.
Don't
so forget to carry your one.
That's right. Doom ka ka tek ka ka tek ka. 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 Doom doom tek a doom doom tek a tek. Tech a doom doom tech a doom doom tech a tech tech a. get your pot down, it's like you could topple a small government with it.
I could topple a small government with it?
With the proper pot.
Well, how do I topple a large government?
You need two Doumbek players, right?
We happen to know a lot of Doumbek players. We could dominate the whole world.
Or at least this part of Florida. Solo phrases.
I don't think I'm ready for that.
It's just a pattern.
It's a pattern, but...
All right, that's the next page. So it's like... Teka-teka-teka-teka.
What is, wait, what did she say on here? Soloing is like speaking or telling a story. Solo phrases can be played over rhythms such as Maksum, Baladi, or Malfu. Every Doumbek player needs to collect a database of solo phrases. The more you have, the more versatile you're playing. You can practice these with a metronome, but it's more fun to have a friend hold down the rhythm for you. Here are some ideas, but it is never too early to try making up your own. Your original solo phrases will eventually define your own voice. When practicing, try repeating each phrase four times. This will prepare you for playing a belly dance drum solo.
And this is exactly some of the things that we were talking about before we started doing this, and that it's, you don't want to get stuck in a rut, because sometimes you may have certain things that you play and that's all you ever play. And it seems like you become, you know, kind of stuck for yourself as a drummer. So learning new solo phrases is really a worthwhile endeavor.
All right, so I think what we should do, so these are each solo phrases.
Yeah.
So we should pick one rhythm and play that rhythm. And you do the solo phrase, well, and then I'll call the solo phrase back.
Right, well, first we should speak the solo phrase, though.
No. Yes.
We speak it.
Fine.
So
all of them?
Well, no, we're just going to do it the first
just
line.
The first
line.
Yeah, we're
just going to do it one at a time. So this solo phrase is teka 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 tek.
Teka 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 tek.
No, I'm sorry. I'm mistaken. Because there's three there, that makes
sense. I know, that's why I'm looking at it. I'm
well,
like,
that reading can be different sometimes when you think about it in your head. I mean, as far as notation goes. So this is teka 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 teka. So
what?
Teka. I mean, once you see it, something like that, that's something that we play all the time. But here's a perfect example. You see it written out, and you don't recognize it for what it is. But when you play it...
Well, no, what I was going to say is, I don't think we need to say these out loud, because you only do that when you're trying to learn rhythm. If you're going to say the solo phrase, I can just repeat it back to you, like a game.
Well, I know, but I need to read it.
You don't get to read, you're just supposed to know it.
You just don't say, oh, I'm just going to play melody. Melody is not some improvisation thing that just runs on for 5 minutes. You actually play a specific thing. So what we can do is this. We'll do the practice with that one. So we'll play the standard drum solo rhythm that's most often heard is just Maksum, which is the Maksum, which we've been playing that. We don't have to play that one. We just go... Leave the nice line. Oh. Now go for it.
That's what that is?
Yeah. Told you it was not.
I can't do that. Okay. I can't. No, I can't. Well, then we need to go much slower because I can't do that.
I'll do it four times.
One time.
Go back and forth.
I'm more comfortable than I've ever been, but I'm not comfortable enough to do that. I can't do that yet. Because my hand technique is like getting thrown away, and it's too soon for me to be able to do that because I haven't fell into a comfortable space. So I think we should jam. Okay. And as promised, I'm going to play handpan for you, Kirsten. I hope you're there.
We challenge you guys to learn something new. Take the time, and it's not that much.
Bye.
See ya.